awesome.
Every day, all day.
This is
this is 97.9, the BOX.
Oh my, it worked. That was so fast.
What's up?
Hi, I'm Young Jas. I'm here in Houston at 97.9 The Box. What's good? Where you at?
I'm in LA. Shout out to you, Young Jas. I appreciate
you. How have you been?
I'm good. Just chilling.
Oh, it's still sunny. Oh, wait, let me over there. I forgot. You still have the daytime over there. How's everything been going on in LA? Like, are more things opening up?
Slowly but surely, yeah. We opening up slowly but surely, yeah.
But y'all not allowed to have any, like, listening parties or nothing like that right now?
Nah, you got to be low-key with everything.
You know, Houston, we've been a little different over here. We never really totally shut down. But look, I'm excited for everybody in H-Town to get to know you tonight. So first off, let's just start with your name, because I'm sure maybe a lot of people think they don't know how to pronounce it, whatever. But your name is your stage name is pronounced Blxst, right?
Blxst. I put an X in it just to be unique when you look it up. I'm the first thing that pop up. So, yeah.
How did you come up with that?
Really, I just made it up, being young, just trying to be cool. I just made it up. The funny thing is, I was going to change it until I had my son. And then when I had looked at it, as me being his superhero. So now I'm Blxst the superhero.
I love it. And what were you going to change it to? I'm just curious.
Yeah, other options, really. But, yeah, I was thinking of changing it for sure.
Have you ever had any other nicknames before?
Nah, not really. Not that I can think of.
I feel like I saw somebody just comment, what's BLA?
Oh, BLA. That's what the homies call me. Like, if you know me personally, they call
me. Oh, my bad. The homies pulling up in the chat. Yeah. What does BLA stand for?
I mean, that was because before I put an X, it was Blxst. And the homies was just calling me BLA the Eagle.
Oh, I see. And Eagle is your label?
Yes, yeah, the brand's the label, absolutely.
Dope. Okay, so we have to talk about how you got started and everything with music. So I saw your uncle was really involved, like he was a rapper artist as well.
Yep, my uncle early on, that was pretty much the first person that introduced me to the art was my uncle. And then I remember when I was young, I told him, I was like, I want to be a rapper. And he was like, if you want to be a rapper, teach me. He was like, teach me a word in a dictionary every day. So every day I would have to find a word. And then tell them the definition. And that's how I fell in love with words in the first place.
And you actually stuck to it every day, doing a different word a day?
Not from then to this. that applied like later on in my art form for sure.
Mm-hmm. And did y'all ever get to do y'all do music together? Have y'all made songs together?
Nah, he a little older than me, so nah.
That's okay. It's okay to work with the old heads too. You're like, nah, that's a different vibe. Is his vibe like old, like, you know, like classic LA?
Yeah, he like more of a backpack type of rapper, hip-hop, like real hip-hop head.
I feel it. And do y'all like, well, he gave you obviously some real good advice there. Your sister also was in a rap group?
So it was him and my sister at the time, for sure.
What? So do y'all have music together, you and your sister?
No, we don't. I think we did make a song together. This was a minute ago, though, but yeah, that was some time ago.
But it's better to keep it. Everybody has their own sound. Everybody in their own lane. I understand that. For sure. Okay, so for somebody who is a brand new fan, Blxst, you got to let them know. Like, you've been popping since the MySpace days. I've seen it. You had the girls' songs on your MySpace and everything. What was your fate? Like, when was the first time that you realized, like, people were gravitating towards the song that you made? Do you remember?
I would say more so recently. I feel like my first win was really, like, me and Bino putting out the 6-tape, that's when I really started finding out who I was. It's more so I was really known for producing. After the 6-tape, that's when people really started paying attention even more.
To your rapping?
Yeah, just to me as an artist in general. Like, yeah. I'm music. People know me, but as far as really, like, what caught wind is the 6-tape.
So did you produce before you started rapping?
It was, like, the same time simultaneously.
What made you, like, get more comfortable? Because, like, even me, I'll be on the radio, but I'm like, I don't want to hear my voice. I don't like to listen to myself ever. Like, how did you get used to hearing more used to yourself in the rap space rather than producer space?
That's crazy because honestly, like way before I was really rapping, before I even started singing, I was real insecure about my like melodic voice. But I felt as I got older, I got more comfortable with my voice, and you know, I feel like I got fuller through puberty, and now I'm just singing more.
You look super young though, still.
I am young.
And you're originally from LA too?
Absolutely.
Okay, so you gotta tell me, Blxst, how do you feel about this title they're giving you? You're the prince of R&B music in LA right now. Do you feel like you feel like it's deserved? Like, yes, I've been doing it finally, or you feel like, whoa, that's a lot for me?
I feel like that's heavy. That's a compliment for sure, but I just take it day by day. Like, I don't let the compliments get to my head. I don't focus on the highs or the lows, but I'm definitely ready to take the torch. Like, I feel like I'm built for it. I feel like I'm made for it. And my city love me. You know, I got love for my city. So I'm definitely that example to be representing the city for sure.
And they're showing you so much love, mad love. I know you had on the extended project, you had Dom Kennedy on there. Like, that's super big. Ty Dolla $ign. Who else was on it?
Bino Rado, Tyga. Yep.
Oh, yeah. Tyga and Ty were on the same song, right?
Yep.
Yeah, somebody said, when is the No Love Lost video release? And I saw there's a dance video for it, though.
The No Love Lost video release? The videos is already out. The only video we haven't put out yet that we're working on is the one with Tyga and Ty Dolla $ign right now.
Ooh. Are y'all still able to work on it even though, you know, like pandemic vibes or whatever?
Yeah, it's a whole system we got to go through, but we're gonna make it happen.
Yes. Okay. And I read online that you used to tweet your music to Kendrick Lamar.
Oh yeah, I definitely used to be thirsty on Twitter, just trying to promote and stuff. But yeah,
that was. Do you feel like it worked?
Hell no. Nah.
What? Okay. So what would you say is the best advice for people trying to get their like genuinely like pop off in music? Because even a lot of people, you know, they'll DM me and send their music, or they might blast it out on Twitter and all that stuff. But like, what was the step that it took for you to actually, like, make it to that next move?
I think ultimately it's just building yourself, being the best version of you at the end of the day. Even back then, I felt like if I would have got on back then, I would have hated myself as an artist, because now that I listen to my old stuff, I cringe, you know what I'm saying? So just I value in the development of self, you know?
And I think artist development is so important, because there's so many people that will, you know, pop off of TikTok or something crazy, and then we don't hear about them the next week. So I feel like good things take time, and good things have growth and all that stuff. So I'm really happy to see everything that you are doing too. The album is so dope from like start to finish. I have to ask, how did you choose the title for it?
It was really just the mode I was in. I felt like No Love Lost really representing my mentality at the time. That's when I was having my son, so I was taking a different transition on how I wanted to approach my music, and I wanted to be in charge. I wanted to have ownership and just tell my own story. And it was No Love Lost to my friends, my family, my loved ones, but this the route I had to take.
Mm-hmm. And do you think that, like, when you had your son, that was a real I was about to say 180. That's not even full circle. It was a full 360 for you. Like, you feel like you just started taking things, like, just looking at life differently?
Absolutely, because it was a different perspective. Like, it was bigger than me now. So I just have more intention behind what I'm doing and more purpose behind everything I do.
And how old is your son now?
He's 3 now.
Oh, does he go to virtual school, or, like, you can actually send him over there?
He's not at school yet.
Oh, is it like preschool?
No, he's not in school yet. He's not in school yet.
Okay, wait, I cut you off, my bad, when you were talking about the Kendrick Lamar thing and the Twitter thing.
What was the question?
I think I said, I think I was like, oh, you used to actually, you know, like tweet and send your music out to K-Dot, and now like you actually know him. So just talk about, you know, how that full circle moment was for you.
Well, I don't really know him, like, personally, but I got the opportunity to produce for him. And, yeah, that was still full circle for me, because back then I used to just promote my music on Twitter and just try to spam it out to everybody. Actually, on one of the beats that I produced for this song, it was a pretty viral song in the city called Do Yo Gutta. He hopped on a remix, and it was crazy. Like, from that point on, I was just fueled to keep going.
That's crazy. Kendrick Lamar and like Kendrick, especially him being from LA too. I feel like we gotta get another collab with y'all too, a rap collab. Could that be in the works possibly?
Absolutely. We're gonna cross paths sooner or later.
Are you already working on the next album?
I'm always in the studio, always recording. So yeah, I'm in that mode for sure. Right now we gearing up for 6 Tape Part 2 with me and Bino, that my debut album.
Do you already have a date for 6 Tape 2?
No set date yet, but we definitely been in the studio for like the past, I want to say 2 weeks for sure.
Dope. That's like, and how did y'all like originally link up? Y'all been like friends for a minute?
One of the homies is named Kaylin. I produced this right with it.
Kaylin, for real?
Absolutely. And then Bino, he reached out to Kaylin. He didn't know who produced it. And then Kaylin exchanged our contacts. And that was our first introduction.
Dang, y'all are a vibe together, too. That's like a natural, organic collab, too. I'd love to see it. Somebody said, are we going to get it this year?
Come on now, of course.
This year? You cranking them out like that?
We got to.
Some people take a minute, though, I feel like, you know, to drop things. And that's okay. I understand that, too. For you, was it like with your debut album, did you want it to be just you, no features, like purposefully? Or did it just turn out that way?
Yeah, it just turned out that way. I'm glad it did, though, because I wanted to show that I can carry my own weight.
Exactly. And that's important.
And that much more.
Are there any other artists that you're looking to collab with soon? Besides, you know.
Nobody off the top of my head, but I just want to build organic relationships as I move forward.
I feel that. So what else is coming up next for you before I let you go?
Like I said, we got the Chosen video with Ty and Tyga coming out. And then we're working on a 6 Tape Part 2, debut album on the way. I shot this. I really can't speak on it too much, but basically we brought the album to life. So I'm going to have some new content for the people for sure.
Film, give us some visuals.
That's all I can really say. Yep.
I'm all about the short films. I feel like it helps bring the project to life. And then we get to see like what the artist wants us to get out of it. And it's just a different perspective. So I love to see it. But look, that's pretty much it. Just making sure everybody in Houston knows about you. We're going to run Overrated tonight. That's one of my favorite songs. I would say, okay, before I let you go, what song, if somebody has never heard any of your music before, what's just one song that you would tell them to listen to get the perfect intro to you? And it doesn't have to be on No Love Lost.
One of my favorite songs that really speak on who I am is Forever Humble. I got a song called Forever Humble. And that really dive deeper on who Blxst is and what I stand for. So that'll be one of my favorite songs to choose.
Bet. Okay, we're going to get Forever Humble. Everybody make sure you tap in. Blxst, look, thank you again for taking the time out to do the live. This is a brand new feature we started doing called Men Making Moves. And I remember I had just started listening to your music like at the end of last year. And I think I interviewed Ryan Destiny. And I asked her who are some artists that I should be on to. And she said you. So that's super dope. Can you give us like 3 artists that you think we should be on to as well?
I'm going to say Compton, TG, E-Hard. That's what I'm listening to a lot. Who else from the city I can shout out? Jason Cash, that's the homie.
Got two.
Eno, Kaylin, you know.
Plug the homies. I feel you. I understand. Well, look, thank you again so much. 9 o'clock tonight in H-Town. We running Overrated, and it's the loyalty of the love for me, too. I feel you. All right. You have a good night.
I appreciate you.
All right. Bye-bye.